To understand autism, you simply can't take a snapshot of any one point in time. Just as children develop over time, the features of autism also develop and change over time. That's why we launched the Autism Phenome Project in 2006. The APP, as it's known, is a longitudinal study. What I mean by longitudinal is that we invite families to bring their children to the Mind Institute just after diagnosis, about 2 to 3 years old. And then we invite the families to come back annually for several years, and then periodically after that. Many of the children that started early on in the Autism Phenome Project are actually coming back as teenagers. And that's our hope, that we're going to be able to follow them into adulthood.
We have information from such a wide range of autistic persons, and that is really unique in a data set to have that kind of information. Also, we have taken painstaking care to evaluate kids on as many of the factors that we possibly can.
The Autism Phenome Project is unique because it includes children with all levels of challenges, with intellectual disability, and with the common co-occurring conditions such as anxiety and gastrointestinal problems.
APP from the start has collected really comprehensive behavioral data, diagnostic information. We do medical exams in the children. We draw their blood so that we can look at immune factors, genetic factors. We also do MRI scans, and we have an EEG component to the APP as well. So we get this really comprehensive picture of what's going on in every child with autism. And then we can start to pick apart different patterns that sort of fit together to try to identify subtypes of children with autism. One strategy is to look at a specific aspect of a child's behavior or a co-occurring medical condition. For example, we can define a subgroup of kids whose IQs change over time, or we can define a subgroup of kids who suffer from serious gastrointestinal problems. We can then look at all of the other data that we've collected, for example, the medical data, the brain imaging data, the immune factors, and we can then try to see what hangs together within a certain subgroup. Using this information, we can better understand the underlying biology with the end goal of developing more effective and specific treatments for each subgroup of autistic children.
What the APP is trying to do is to figure out those factors that lead to the best possible outcome for an autistic child. And if we can predict those children that have the most serious challenges, to hopefully intervene to improve their chances for a high quality of life.
We know that there are fewer girls diagnosed with autism. We've shown in some of our studies from the APP that there are different biological, at least neurobiological signatures from boys and girls with autism. And so we're really delving into that more and looking into how subgrouping may be different based even on what gender you are, what biological sex you are, in relation to how your brain is growing and what your behavioral presentation is.
We found that about 15% of autistic boys have enlarged brains. It turns out this is a type of autism that doesn't seem to affect girls as much.
We know a very large percentage of kids with autism have anxiety. So we're running a clinical trial, which is very unique in the field. It's the first to look at medication, pill placebo, and also a psychosocial intervention that's been shown to be the most effective for anxiety and autism, and kind of see which of these treatments is most effective and which is most effective for whom, because that's very important when we're trying to tailor treatments.
One of the things that I really treasure about the Autism Phenome Project is being able to get to know the families that have participated in our study, some as early as 2006. I have gotten to see their children grow up. I've gotten to know the parents in the study and share experiences and see how their children are doing. And it's been one of the most rewarding parts of conducting this really large-scale longitudinal study.
There is no study in the world that is as far-reaching and inclusive as the Autism Phenome Project. This is truly a unique partnership between families, scientists, and clinicians to improve the quality of life of autistic individuals worldwide.